everyone. Welcome back to another update for the Tour of Duty ride. I'm the community manager for the Benefit Fund, Robert Allen, and joining me today is Linda Giammona, our executive director, and we have with us a special guest who's going to be joining the ride for the last leg with Linda, police officer Steve Lindy. Steve, thank you so much for joining us today.
No problem. Good morning.
We wanted to get together and just kind of give everyone a little bit of an update on where we're at with the ride and introduce Steve to everyone. We'll be following his progress through that last leg of the ride as the Tour of Duty team makes it to New York City. But before we get into that, Linda, why don't you give us a little bit of an update on what's been going on with you and the ride so far?
Well, the team is now in Tennessee, in Memphis, and if you're following either our blog, which is answerthecallblog.org, or tourofdutyride.com, you'll see some great photos and footage from what's happening with the team. I'm especially grateful to speak with Police Officer Lindy this morning, because this is the first time we're actually communicating face-to-face. We've been emailing and texting each other for about 2 months now. And I'm just so happy to finally put a smile to those words that I've been receiving. So, as you had mentioned, Police Officer Lindy is going to be joining us in D.C., and I'm sure he has a lot of questions about what a typical day is and what expectations are and so forth. But I wanted to welcome him and let him know that I'm so happy to have part of New York's finest joining the team. There's two firefighters that have been part of the ride, Liam Flaherty and Will Downey from the New York City Fire Department. So I think we're finally having some New York in the house. So I think by the time we get to the city on September 10th, we're going to have a nice crowd waiting for us. So I hope, Steve, you're ready for this.
I'm absolutely ready. You know, I've been training to ride, a lot of riding, and I just can't wait to meet this Australian-American team. I'm really excited about it.
What's it been like, Linda, to go through the different cities and to see the reception of not only first responders, but just citizens of those cities? I'm sure that's an incredible feeling as you kind of arrive at each new city.
Yes, it's been really rewarding. As you may know, I've been riding with the names of our fallen firefighters and police officers on my handlebars every day. And so when I pull into a fire station or if there's a stop along the way and we meet people from whatever town we're in, you know, I know they're there for us. So when they see the names of these people that I'm riding in honor of, that just makes them feel more connected with what it is that this Tour of Duty ride is all about and what our charity is all about. So I would let Steven know that be prepared for a lot of hugs and a lot of, you know, thank you so much, because, you know, as a police officer, you may not get a lot of thank yous, unfortunately, but on this ride, you will be certainly appreciated, and a lot of people will want to just, you know, throw their arms around you and say thank you for doing what you do. There was one family in particular that I had met, a mother and a father who had lost their son last year. He was a police officer, and his bracelet was given to me. I don't know if you can see it, but it's Officer Brad Jones.
Yeah, I see it. Very nice.
And his mom and dad were just so moved by the Tour of Duty ride and what this ride is all about, which is remembering not to forget those police officers and firefighters and military that put their lives on the line for us every day. And they were just so moved by that, that they wanted to join us. And so they wound up riding like 45 miles with us. And so that's another thing that you'll have. You know, you'll go through a town or a city and you'll be greeted by people who really celebrate what our first responders and what our military is doing for our countries. And they'll want to be part of it. So I have to say it's been very rewarding.
So Steve, what was the motivation for you? I mean, after learning about the ride, for making that decision to say, hey, I want to be part of this. What was that process like for you?
Well, for me, it was an easy decision. I've got approximately 10 years serving in the U.S. Marine Corps. Been on the police force a little over 4 years. This cause is, you know, is great. And, you know, any cause like this, I'm always willing to support and back. 9/11, I lost some people also. Overseas lost some people. And, you know, it's great to give back, you know, as you guys said earlier.
What's been the response so far from your fellow officers that know you're going to be doing this?
Everybody's 100% behind me, friends, officers, family members. Same thing, everybody's been sharing the tour duty page. And it's a great response. You know, a lot of people are very into it, more people than you would actually think, you know. So it's been very good, very positive.
That's great. Well, it's going to be very exciting when you guys roll into town here. I'm sure New York is going to roll out the red carpet for everyone, and it's really going to be something, especially for you guys and for everyone locally involved with the ride. I'm sure everyone's looking forward to pulling into New York.
Yep, definitely looking forward to that.
That's good. So, Linda, what are you looking forward to the most for this last leg of the ride?
I think after riding through our great country and seeing all the different types of people and towns that we have here to celebrate, I think ending up in New York City, our hometown, is really going to be the icing on the cake for me. You know, as Steve said, having your family support you and your friends and your co-workers support you, there's nothing like that. You know, you want to do it for all those right reasons, and you want to make everyone proud of this ride and your participation. And I think when the ride culminates and concludes in New York City, especially on September 10th in New York City, I think it's really going to bring our town together as our town was brought together 11 years ago. So it's probably going to be moving. I wouldn't be surprised if I cry again, because I've been doing a lot of crying. But that's not a requirement, by the way, Stephen. You don't have to worry about that. Got that covered. But I just think up in New York City is going to be really powerful for not just the New Yorkers who are participating, but I also think for the Australians and for our fellow Americans who are participating in this ride that represent the U.S. military and firefighters and police officers.
That's great. Well, we're certainly looking forward to being with you guys as you arrive in New York, along with all of the supporters who have stepped up so far to help support the ride, and for those who will do so over the next couple of weeks. You too can support the ride by visiting our website, answerthecall.org, our blog, which is answerthecallblog.org, and of course our Facebook page, which has all of the updates and pictures and videos multiple times a day. So make sure that you like our Facebook page so that you get all of the updates. We still need people to support the ride, so you can sponsor a mile on our blog site. Make sure you do that. If you'd like to purchase the commemorative coins from the ride, head on over to touroftuturide.com and you can get those coins there. Any final thoughts before we sign off here today, Linda or Steve?
Well, Linda, you want to go first?
Yeah, I want to invite anyone who's watching and listening to join us on September 10th. We will be ending in New York City. The destination and the time will be sent out on another video. So I just hope you stay posted. Just know that if you are in New York, we're coming your way. And if you're available, on the 10th to please come by and be part of our finish. It's going to be a really special moment. So I hope you can join us, and we'll be forwarding the details about the when and the where and the time shortly.
Yeah, same thing. I'm just really excited to join up with you guys. And I can't wait. I'm really excited. But, you know, I trained for a long time for it too. And I want to get this done and get with you guys already. So I'm looking forward.
Great. Oh, that's great. That's great.
Well, we're looking forward to the last few weeks of the ride here. We want to thank everyone for joining us today for this update for the Tour of Duty Ride 2012. We've been chatting with Police Officer Steve Lindy, who will be joining the ride for the final leg, and of course our Executive Director Linda Giammona, who's already ridden almost close to 1,000 miles already, and will be riding some more as the Tour of Duty Ride 2012 makes its way to New York City. Thank you to everyone for all of your support up until now. We really appreciate it. All of the great comments on our Facebook page and our blog has been so inspirational for us. Please keep it coming, and we'll be bringing you more updates from the road. You've been watching the Tour of Duty Ride update. My name is Robert Allen. I'm the community manager for the New York Police and Fire Widows and Children's Benefit Fund. Thank you again for joining us and for supporting the Tour of Duty Ride 2012.